Parks Bros. It's Drew here, and we're coming to you from Magic Mountain. No, not Six Flags Magic Mountain. Magic Mountain in Big Bear Lake, which is home to currently the only operating coaster in Southern California right now during the pandemic. Now, I'm already kind of wary. There are a crap load of cars in this parking lot, and most people are not wearing masks. So I am actually a little uncomfortable already with trying to go in at the moment. But there is a lot of people. There's an Alpine slide here, which I'm excited to check out, and an Alpine coaster, which just recently opened up. Super excited to both check those out. The Alpine slide is $7 and the coaster is $20. So I don't think I'll be doing many rides on either of them, but it'll be nice to get on a ride, I think, for the first time since March 18th of this year. It's been that long. The last ride I rode was Indiana Jones Adventure at Disneyland. I'm excited though, because it will be my first Alpine slide and coaster ever, so that'll be a heck of a lot of fun. But I'll keep you guys updated on everything that's going on here at Magic Mountain in Big Bear for the day. We're probably only gonna be here for about an hour at this rate though. So as you can see, Alpine coaster right here, there's the end of it right there, ending helix as well. Super excited to check this out. They also have go-karts, mini golf, Screaming Eagle, which is a zip line attraction. This is really cool. Super excited to check out the coaster for sure. I don't know if we'll be doing like three rides or anything though, especially since it costs $20 a ride. It's quite expensive, but we'll see how much I like it, and we'll see how comfortable everything is once we get inside. So here's just a quick look at the safety information. Speaking of safety, man, we just walked by the Alpine slide line. There is no social distancing whatsoever going on. Most people are wearing the mask, but there definitely is not a lot of people wearing the mask. So I'm probably only going to do the coaster just once, too. I must say, all the theming is very nice in here, though. But 20 bucks, there's barely any line over here, thankfully, compared to the Alpine slide, which is packed to the brim. So just got off the Mineshaft coaster. Sadly, no filming allowed on the ride. So I did bring my GoPro Max to hopefully film some 360. That is not the case on this attraction at the moment. There is no filming whatsoever on the ride. Kept my mask on the whole time, of course. A lot of people I saw weren't doing that, especially on the Alpine slide. Definitely not going to check that out today because it's just too packed. The coaster though, because it is kind of pricey at $20 a ride, has a heck of a lot less of a line, which is great. So we checked it out, really loved it. Super hectic. I don't know if I'd pay 20 bucks again, but 15 would definitely pay to ride that over and over. It was 15 bucks. Super fun. Reminded me a heck of a lot of the Matterhorn at times, especially going full speed. There were some awesome floater moments, lots and lots of laterals, and I gotta say, really surprised me in a lot of good ways. But it was one of the most hectic coasters I think I've been on out of the over 100 I've been on. Super fun though. You should definitely come check it out if you're in the Big Bear area for sure. So some interesting things I thought I'd mention. There's actually quite a bit of theming on the ride, especially in this last turnaround. And there's two different mine shafts that you go through, or tunnels, and two major lift hills, which are very bizarre. One, the second lift hill actually goes like from 45 degrees to like 20 degrees and then drops again. And then there's another lift hill onto the end of it. You can actually see part of it in the background there. Super fun though overall. But if you're wondering where the station is, it's actually over to the left of the actual main building. So it is a little confusing trying to find it. You do buy your tickets over here. They are $20 each, as I've said multiple times now. You do sign a waiver prior to purchasing, though. So make sure you do that. And that's just because you technically have control of the speed. So as you can see there, she was using handles to use brakes. So definitely make sure you're braking. And you want to keep an 80-foot distance. So there's markers all along the track saying 80 feet here, 80 feet here, just to make sure you're keeping, paying attention to that distance. So here's just a quick look at that first lift hill. It does head up behind those trees. And then of course, here's the Alpine slide, the main attraction technically at the park, next to some water slides, which is kind of cool. And then you can see the second lift hill off in the distance, as well as one of the mine shafts just there, which is kind of cool. Also, some really good floater moments, I gotta say, especially if you're going full speed. Kind of scared me, actually, a little bit. Especially the laterals on this thing are incredible. But if you can see behind the water slide and behind that second lift hill, it does come around those trees over there, and we'll get some more shots of that in a second. But it comes over the walkway, which is a cool view. And to mention cool views, if you look behind you while you're on the lift hill, you get an amazing view of the lake itself, which is really beautiful. But for sanitization, I just wanted to mention that they do have sanitizer outside the before you get on to the ride itself, which is great. And of course, we used it before and after. just to make sure. And they are wiping down every individual car. So here's our best vantage point of most of this second half of the coaster. Actually, this is the end of the first half, I should say, because this leads into the second lift hill. But really cool turnaround there, you can see, which is a lot of fun. Lots of laterals throughout this entire section. And I really, really enjoyed all of it. But of course, the natural landscaping of Big Bear itself with all the rocks and the trees make it a really scenic ride as well. So definitely should check it out if you can. So, thoughts on Magic Mountain at Big Bear Lake. It's crowded. It is very crowded. We did come on a Wednesday at about 2 p.m. So maybe it's just because we came at 2 p.m. instead of 10 a.m. like we probably should have with opening, that it was a little more busy than I was hoping. But the coaster itself had maybe, what, 3-4 people in front of us, which was not bad at all. Where the Alpine slide, when we walked by, it did have quite a lengthy wait, and there was no social distancing going on over there. But I will say, with the Mineshaft coaster, some of the employees over there were super friendly and nice. Actually, one of them was offering to hold my GoPro Max for me while I rode, and I got it back in peace. And I gotta say thank you so much for holding it for me, since we weren't allowed to film at the park, which is something I didn't see anywhere on the rules. Maybe I just missed it. But yeah, so apparently the park just doesn't want us to film, at least for the time being. And it's probably just because when they first opened it, maybe a lot of people brought on their phones and then lost phones, and then they tried to get them back and all this crazy stuff. And trying to get phones back from the side of a mountain like this, and especially with a coaster that takes up so much space, it's just gonna take a heck of a long time, and it really just ends up being a pain in the side for the park itself. So I think they just went no filming, just to limit, you know, the amount of objects that have been fallen off and things like that. Now I will say, a lot of people were not social distancing. A lot of people weren't wearing masks, which really stinks, because I would have loved to do other things at the park, but I'm happy with getting my 110th credit with the Mineshaft coaster. And funnily enough, that is my first new coaster of the year. It is July. Actually, it's August now, and that was my first new coaster of the year, and my first coaster ridden since March. Weird. Very, very weird. But now we're probably just gonna head back home. I'm gonna shower for sure, because I feel really gross, especially with how many people were there and how everything was outside, at least. And thankfully it was outside for all of the, you know, unsafe social distancing measures that were going on, I would say. Well, not on the park's fault, but just because people weren't caring. So it had no problem with the park on their enforcement. It's just people coming here just didn't care, which really does stink, because people need to care about this so we can start to open bigger parks sooner. And honestly, I'm kind of surprised this park is even open at the moment. This is one of two coasters operating in California at the moment, and the other one is up in Sacramento. But yeah, time to head home, shower. Already sanitized a bunch of times, but Mineshaft coaster, I would definitely say check it out if you can come at opening or just a calmer time of the day. Also, I would say check it out, you know, when you can. I mean, if you're up at Big Bear, it's definitely a nice little tourist attraction. And for 20 bucks, I'd say it is not a bad value. I would rather pay about 15 for it, but 20, honestly, with how long the ride is, I think it was about 11, 12 minutes in full length. I'm not sure, especially with the two lift hills. It might have even been longer than that, but it was a full ride experience and definitely super enjoyable. Loved the ride itself. The laterals were the star of that, I think, for sure, because there are just a bunch of twists and turns. And if you're going full speed, it is insane. I mean, it's like Matterhorn almost on steroids, if that makes sense. Maybe not theming wise. Well, maybe I should say theming wise, because you're actually on a real mountain this time, but so much fun. Felt a lot different than any other coaster I've ever ridden, and I'm super excited and happy that I was able to ride an Alpine coaster for the first time ever and get my first new coaster of 2020. What a year. But thank you all so much for watching. But until next time, we'll see you on the next ride.